Good morning, children, and welcome back to your civics class. Today we'll start our third chapter, that is constitutional design. This chapter will help you to understand why do we need constitution. We'll try to understand how our Indian constitution has been formed by comparing the constitution of different nations. So we'll start up with the chapter with the unit 1, that is democratic constitution in South Africa. We'll try to understand how South African constitution was made, and then we will understand why do we need constitution. Okay, so let's start up with the first unit, page number 41. Here, you know, the first paragraph talks about certain words given by Nelson Mandela. He had a great contribution in the freedom of South Africa. He has been imprisoned for 28 years in South Africa in a very deadly prison. And he has worked very hard to get freedom from the white people. There was a system in South Africa which is called apartheid. Okay. So he has fought against that system. Now, what was the system of apartheid? You can underline this. Apartheid was the name of the system of racial discrimination unique to South Africa. Like in India, you know, European companies have also started trading in South Africa. But unlike India, there are many European company people, they have white people who have settled there in South Africa. And they started dividing the people on the basis of their color, that is races. However, they are in majority, African people, they are like 3/4 in majority. But still, they are being ruled by white people. There were other color people also, like from India and various other places, but they are being considered as non-white. So there was a system of segregation in South Africa where, you know, different facilities are there for white, and this was an official segregation. That means people, white people were treated in a different way and non-whites were treated in a different way. They had a different facilities. Starting from trains, buses, church, you know, hospitals, everything. Also, you know, workship places are different for whites and non-whites. So we called it as a system of segregation. You can underline these lines. The system of apartheid divided the people and labeled them on the basis of their skin color. The native people of South Africa are black in color. They made up about 3/4 of population and they were called as black. Okay, beside these two groups of white and black, there are certain people of mixed races who are called colored and people who migrated from India. The white rules treated all nine non-whites as inferior. And these non-whites do not have voting rights. Please underline that. Even they do not have a voting rights. And how they are being discriminated. Let's underline that also. The apartheid system was particularly oppressive for black. They were forbidden from living in the white area. If they have to work in white area, they have to go with a permit card and then they have to come back. Okay. They could work in white area only if they have permit. Train, buses, taxis, hotel, hospitals, colleges, swimming pools, public toilets were all separated for white and black. Okay. So this was the system of segregation. But however, they cannot form the association or organization to fight against this. This was a rule. Since 1950, the black, colored and Indian fought against the system of apartheid. Then they have formed, you know, they have done a lot of strikes, marches, you know, protest, but nobody has listened to them. Then they have formed an organization which was called African National Congress. Please underline that. And it was an umbrella organization that leaded the struggle against the policy of segregation. There were many white people also who have supported this organization. And it was leaded by Nelson Mandela. And finally, because of this organization, they got freedom from this. Okay, so it was a, you know, long journey, but they got success because they were united and they have fought for it. Now, in the next class, we'll try to understand how they have formed their constitution. That is very interesting when they get independent. Okay, so we'll end up here today. In the next class, we'll try to understand how South African constitution was formed. Okay, thank you, children.